Hi, I'm Chad Wahlquist. I'm an architect here at Palantir. I've been working in the data analytics and AI space for the last 15 plus years. I have seen these architectures and systems evolve over time, and the enterprise software landscape is more fragmented now than ever. It has turned into a true Tower of Babel, where no one can seem to communicate or work together. Different scaling functions, security mechanisms, data format. Instead, each promotes their own isolated interest at the expense of the system as a whole. However, though, in the enterprise, it's a system of systems. I see some of the most viral posts online about these hyper-complex market maps, open source tools, and VC-backed vendors pitching their easy-to-sell box on someone's architecture diagram. The problem with this is the focus is not on how the system as a whole will add value to your organization, but on how each point solution can be sold. Enterprises are already facing increased complexity, and now you layer in AI on top of that. What I see is AI adding a non-linear, stepwise increase in that complexity to the entire software stack, threatening to topple this tower. When customers come to AIPCon or analysts talk to our customers with AIP use cases in production, they ask the same thing. How is Palantir the only one enabling AI in production operations? We've spent the last 20 plus years in operational use cases in the toughest environments in the world. We have hundreds of our forward deployed engineers on the ground at the edge with our customers, eating the pain and building the product that matters to our customers, not for an architecture diagram. So how are we doing this? Today, I'm going to walk you through how we approach this differently. All right, before we get into the architecture, we're going to show you from an operational application back to the sources so you have a point of reference. So this is a workshop application of a supply chain control tower that allows me to build these data-rich applications that are bi-directional and write back. I can take action through these applications. It's not just a report. We also have AI agents embedded in here. So I have agents seen and looking as data is coming in through my platform and helping me reason through how to resolve different issues, whether they can do it autonomously or even exit and ask for human help. This is AI and human teaming. If we then look at those agents, you can see here, this is AIP logic. I actually have the ability to create system prompts. I give it access to tools. I can give it access to data. I can give it access to functions, or it can apply actions or take actions on my behalf. I can call forecasting functions, all of this in one interface. And I can then even switch out which models I want from a model catalog that I can populate with a default set, or I can even bring my own model endpoints or my own fine-tuned models if I would like. And then each logic block can actually use different models. So the right model for the different prompts, so you can mix and match and use them together. This is super powerful. And then if we look at workflow builder here, this is that same application and all of the ontology objects that it's using to actually represent this application, which is great. And the cool thing is then I can also take those same functions I build in this application and then build a custom application, custom integration on top of there. So in this example, I also have on that same set of ontology objects, a Titan satellite tasking application that's built on our Ontology SDK. The Ontology SDK here actually generates a custom SDK based on your ontology objects. It creates the documentation, everything you need to know, and the packages to integrate on top of the ontology. Even pick your language of choice here. Very cool. Then, if we get back to the ontology, we talk about an ontology object. This is actually an ontology object. Normally you would have a dimension and a data warehouse that is a tabular data set. You can see how rich this is. I also have streams. I have linked data. I have geospatial. I have schematics. I can have video, images, all of that in one ontology object, no longer just tabular data. How do we populate ontology objects? The ontology objects are the blue objects over here on the right. These are the nouns and verbs that make up the data, logic, and actions of your business so that you can make decisions. So how do we hydrate that? That's through all of these pipelines that you can see running here. So these different data pipelines can be pro code or low code. So you can run Python, Java, SQL to transform your data across these pipelines to hydrate these objects. You can also have multimodal data. I can look here and I have Snowflake, so I can register data through virtual tables from your own data warehouse without copying it. I can get APIs, I can get SAP, I can use our Hyper Auto to actually build these transforms for me. I also have streaming data from OPCUA. All of those things coming together in one single pane of glass into these ontology objects that I build these data-rich applications. All right, that's top to bottom. This is the Palantir AI Mesh architecture. These eight core capabilities are essential for delivering true enterprise AI at scale. Today, we'll explore how these components integrate and are interoperable with your existing landscape. Starting with outcomes in mind, we have a product building services. There are two main areas. First up is our pre-built AI products. We have AIP Now offerings that can be installed in minutes, integrated with your unique data, logic, and actions, and then customized as needed. This is an easy button for enterprise apps. We also have Build with AIP, a set of developer-focused starter packs to accelerate time to delivery of things like LM vision models to extract data from unstructured sources. It's pretty cool. For custom build applications, we offer a suite of tools for analytics, whether it be time series, geospatial, AI-assisted deep dives. Additionally, we provide operational app building ranging from low code to full pro code and even mixed reality. Our developer tool chain focuses on getting your work into production, whether through the Ontology SDK for fully custom apps or integrations, a marketplace to consume from or contribute to, or even integrated DevOps tool chain. The key theme here is building integrated AI experiences and getting them into production as quickly and safely as possible. All of the analytics and applications within AIP are built upon the Ontology. The Ontology is designed to represent the decisions in an enterprise, not merely the data. It addresses the core challenge that every organization faces, executing the best possible decisions, often in real time, amidst constantly changing internal and external conditions. The Ontology facilitates deep two-way interoperability with existing enterprise systems. So this setup enables the rapid development of operational applications with AI teaming, in addition to conventional business intelligence and analytics workflows. Every decision can be broken down into three core components: data, logic, and actions. So we think about data. These are the relevant facts or truths about your world, the nouns and verbs of your operation that form the context for each decision. Then logic. This encompasses the organizational and business rules that act as the guardrails for your decisions. Each includes understanding of the probabilities of certain outcomes under different assumptions, past experiences in similar situations, and inputs from forecast and optimization models. And then actions. These represent the kinetics or the effects of a decision. They describe how the decision manifests in the real world and the detailed steps needed to translate a decision within AIP to a tangible outcome in a production setting. Okay, so by automatically integrating all these components, the Ontology not only simplifies, but also accelerates the journey from decision-making to real-world action. This is key to enabling AI, as the Ontology grounds LMs in the truth of your business operations and decisions. This is crucial because when you're modeling the digital twin of your business process in the Ontology, it's not just data. It's a digitized business process that is the backbone of your operation that also acts as the semantic layer for LMs to bring reasoning and automation capabilities. All of this is secured with a full audit trail, explainable chain of thought reasoning, and gives a level of transparency so that human and AI work together. This shared decision model is key to adoption, integrity, and scale. All right, moving down the stack from the Ontology, we have data services, AI services, and workflow services. Let's dive a little bit deeper into the data services. We think of this in three main areas: connectivity, integration, and management. You can ingest and process in batch, micro batch, CDC, and streaming as a first-class citizen. So AI thrives on streaming data for real-time feedback loops, and we'll get into that more in the AI services in a minute. You have over 150 out-of-the-box connections, plus the ability to build your own connector. I have yet to find a system we can't connect to. Our HyperAuto tool automates data transformations, turning complex systems like SAP into usable ontologies within hours and days. Pipeline Builder, it's for multimodal data. Think of structured, unstructured, media, PDF, images, stream building, LLM processing blocks for inline context and reasoning. All of this on an ultra-scalable infrastructure. All of these tools support data as code, allowing me to branch my data along with my code, versioning, lineage tracking, all of this built upon the same unified and security and governance. Even this, in the data services, we have AIP Assist integrated for help with pipeline building, error resolution, offering up code suggestions and explanations in real time. If we take a step over to AI services, we have three main areas: model connectivity, model training, and model operation. In model connectivity, we have many ways to integrate models that you've built, bought, or downloaded an open source one. You can host models in AIP externally and register them, bring containerized models that have robust dependencies, or select from an open source model that you can use out of the box. The idea here is any model anywhere can be integrated into a workflow in AIP. Then to model training. You have a secure hosted JupyterLab notebook, RStudio, code workbooks. You can even use Pipeline Builder with a containerized training run. The idea is you have all the tools you need inside the secure enclave of AIP to prepare, cleanse your data, and then securely train your models. Lastly is model operations. Let's get it to production at scale, right? We have the concept of modeling objectives that facilitates multiple scientists and builders building, submitting, and comparing models against each other or scoring against a third party model as well, all towards the same goal of a better model. You can evaluate, release, host, and monitor your models. All of this comes together in an integrated end-to-end MLOps framework, again, built on the same security and governance foundations. Now in workflow services, we have three areas: workflow building, decision orchestration, and edge integration. Starting in workflow building, we have an aptly named workflow builder that we showed you earlier, model-based execution, process mining, automation framework. In decision orchestration, we have batch, CDC, and streaming writeback, along with even native client writeback like SAP Boppies. Then in edge integrations, we have edge pipelines, edge models, and edge objects. Bring your own device or Apollo managed devices. The idea here is we meet you where you are, and this is super powerful to model your business processes. Next up, we have security and governance, which spans infrastructure, platform, and enterprise security. This includes automated security patching, continuous monitoring, secure model hubs, role-based, marking-based, and purpose-based access controls, approval frameworks, and even granular audit and logging. And at the base is Apollo, a product we developed to deploy and manage software like AIP and Foundry. Apollo orchestrates hundreds of microservices, enabling quick deployment, updates, and even things out to the edge. This foundational layer ensures our forward deployed engineers can innovate rapidly and deploy new features for you at the edge, as we talked about before. This is just a small slice of what there is, but if you think about it, just these two bottom boxes alone, this would be a myriad of tools that you have to stitch together, and everything above it would be even harder to implement. AI needs this secure foundation across the board, and we need tools like Apollo to deploy and innovate rapidly. All right, I know that was a speed run through the AI mesh architecture, but I hope you get the point that the end of the day, it's about how do I drive outcomes. And this integrated platform with a unified security, governance, and deployment model allows you to move quickly, the speed of your thought, to drive outcomes, not worry about stitching all these tools together and how do you do it in a safe and secure way. So when you layer Gen AI on top of this, these models are very unpredictable. They hallucinate. How do you manage that? How do you evaluate? How do you pick the right model for the right use cases? How do you do that in a production manner and manage it over time? All these tool sets only add an extra level of complexity across your entire tech stack. Now, this is where the AI mesh comes in because it also integrates with your existing tool sets. So we can integrate through APIs, SDKs. It's an unwalled garden for your enterprise. So at the end of the day, if it's not in production, it's not adding value.